Bill, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, good afternoon, guys.
Hi, Bill.
I work for the PATH trains up in northern New Jersey.
Yes.
And the you had mentioned that one of my things that's really melted into my memory is as an employee, we ride the trains all different hours. Seeing somebody take their shoes off, you'd mentioned that earlier, mm-hmm. and then begin to trim their toenails with their teeth.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, my God. And where were the clippings going?
Oh, my.
They were just doing, doing their thing, spitting on the floor. And,
they're just spitting the little clippings onto the floor.
It's so nasty.
Whoa. Okay, yeah, now, was it your job to say something to them?
We try to, but we're only allowed to go so far as interacting with the passengers and such. There's legality there, so
right.
We notify the appropriate personnel, and we just move on and try to if anybody else is in the area, move them out of the immediate vicinity for their protection.
I don't know. I was going to say, who's the appropriate personnel? A mental hospital?
Well, we start with the police department, and then usually they who knows where they go after that, but. There's all kinds of stuff.
Like, what else have you seen?
On the poles. Oh, we see strip teasers on the poles. We see...
How often? And which which train can I see that?
Bill wants to know which schedule, which car number.
Usually it's the 33rd Street line.
Yes.
After one of the big holidays or a parade type event where there's a lot of drunken people aboard, there's all kinds of shenanigans going on. And, they curb it to the best they can. There's a heavy police activity, presence, and certain things still transpire at different times.
Okay, and now you work for PATH?
Yes, sir.
Okay, correct me if I'm wrong. No food or drink allowed on the trains, right?
Correct.
Okay, then why do 75% of the people on the PATH trains have a cup of coffee?
That's a great question. Again, as employees, there's only so much that we could do within our rights as, working for the system. We try to politely remind people, and you get the shrug off the look, and they just do their thing, go back to reading their little tablets and papers and such.
Yeah, I always feel like such a rube because I throw mine out before I get on the train.
Or go back to watching the strip pole.
Yeah.
So, Bill, now go back to the pole thing. You've seen people kind of doing a pole dance on the trains. Have you ever seen somebody get almost or entirely naked?
No, I have not. Close to it, and then usually a friend, or again the heavy police presence during those times.
So you've seen like drunk girls swinging on a pole as if they're in a strip club, and they'll be what? They'll get topless?
They start the process usually. They'll start unbuttoning or that kind of thing, and then somebody will come along it and stop it. But there's been a few occasions before I worked there that I've seen full topless. But it's guys, girls, young, old. It's
really?
Everybody at different points. Yeah.
Nice.
That's funny.
All right. Thank you so much, Bill. Thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5.